Hello students, in this video we are going to learn Standard 10 Science and Technology Part 2, new topic, topic number 1, Heredity and Evolution. So, in this chapter we talk about heredity, hereditary changes, transcription, translation, translocation and human evolution. When we talk about heredity, the definition of heredity is that transfer of biological characters from one generation to another generation, means our generation and our previous generation. That is, our parental generation, there is a resemblance, there is similarity. Similarity in the characteristics like our hairs, our skin color, our intelligence, there is similarity with our mother or our father, and it is called as the genetics. From this conclusion, we can make a simple definition of heredity is the transfer of biological characters from one generation to another generation via genes. You already studied in previous standard that segments of DNA molecule are called as genes. The genes are arranged in a line. Genes control the structure and function of the cell of the body and also the transfer heredity characters from parents to offspring. So, genes are said to be functional unit of heredity. So, another definition of heredity is transfer of characteristics from parents to offspring is called as heredity. Due to heredity, that puppies are similar to dogs, crabs are similar to pigeons and infants are similar to human. That is why many similarities are seen between parents and their offspring. Offspring produced through sexual reproduction show more variation, while those asexual reproduction have comparatively much lesser variations. All of you are in standard 10. Why then are some students tall and some are short? Though all of us are in same standard, each one has different type of inherited characters from their respective parents. Therefore, there are variation in the skin color. Now, we see some introductory questions in the textbook, page number 1. Can you recall which component of the cellular nucleus of living organisms carries hereditary characters? The answer, the chromosomes made up of nucleic acid and protein present in the nucleus of the cells are components of the cellular nucleus of living organism. What do we call to the process of transfer of physical and mental characters from parents to the progeny? Answer, inheritance or heredity. Question number 3. Which are the components of the DNA molecule? Answer, each strand in the molecule of DNA is made up of many small molecules known as nucleotide and 4 types of nitrogenous bases and phosphoric acid. Already depending upon our previous knowledge, the structure in the nucleus of the cells that carries the hereditary characteristics is called as chromosome. It is made up of mainly nucleic acid and proteins. During cell division, chromosomes can be clearly seen under compound microscope. This is structure of chromosome. Each chromosome is made up of DNA and it appears dumbbell shaped. There is constricted region on which it is called primary constriction or centromere. Centromere divides chromosome into 2 parts and each part is called as an arm. P arm and Q arm is present. There are 4 types of chromosomes: metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, telocentric. Genes which contain the information about hereditary characteristics in coded form which are located on chromosomes. Chromosome number of some organisms has been given in the following table. Chromosome number of some organisms has been given in the following table. Organism and number of chromosomes. First, crab, 200 chromosomes. Midge, 20 chromosomes. Frog, 26 chromosomes. Roundworm, 4 chromosomes are present. Potato, 48. And in human being, 46 chromosomes are present. That is 23 pairs. Out of these 23 pairs, 22 pairs are autosomes and 1 pair is sex chromosome. Now we see DNA structure. In 1953, Watson and Crick produced a model of DNA molecule. This is DNA structure that are found by Watson and Crick's model. DNA molecule is a double helix consisting of two strands. Each strand of this helix is made up of nucleotides. Each strand of this helix is made up of phosphoric acid, a deoxyribose sugar and nitrogenous base. Nitrogenous bases are also two types, purines and pyrimidines. The purines are of two types, adenine and guanine, and pyrimidines are of two types, cytosine and thymine. The adenine always pairs with thymine with double hydrogen bonds, while cytosine always pairs with guanine with triple hydrogen bond. DNA are present in all organisms from viruses and bacteria to human being. These molecules control the functioning, growth and division of the cell, are therefore called master molecules. From above all conclusions, heredity is the transfer of biological characters from one generation to another generation via genes. And genes which contain information about hereditary characteristics in coded form, which are located on chromosome. Is it clear? Now we see next point, history of genetics. The scientists and their discoveries and their contribution already discussed. History of genetics starts in 1886. So the scientist Gregor John Mendel in year 1886 performs various experiments on pea plant to explain inheritance. Later these principles becomes popular by his name. So he called pioneer of modern genetics and also called father of genetics. It took long period to understand the conclusion and research about heredity. Again, in 1901, Hugo de Vries discovered sudden changes were understood due to mutational theory. In 1902, scientists Walter and Sutton observed paired chromosomes in grasshopper cells. In 1944, Oswald Avery, McLean McCarthy and Colleen McLeod proved that except viruses, all living organisms have DNA as genetic material. In 1961, the French scientists Francois Jacob and Jack Monod proposed a model of protein synthesis with the help of DNA in bacterial cells. Then, the benefits of science of heredity. First benefit means useful in diagnosis of hereditary disorders, treatment of incurable hereditary disorders, then prevention of hereditary disorders. Also, it is useful in production of hybrid varieties of animals and plants. Some disorders occur due to numerical changes in chromosomes, such as Down syndromes, Klinefelter syndrome, Turner syndrome, etc. Some monogenic disorders caused due to mutations such as sickle cell anemia, albinism and night blindness, etc. Polygenic disorders also occur such as diabetes, blood pressure, heart disorders, asthma, obesity. These are polygenic disorders. RNA is second important nucleic acid of the cell. Long form of RNA is ribose nucleic acid, having single strand of ribonucleotides. Each nucleotide is made up of ribose sugar, phosphate molecules and nitrogenous bases. For example, adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. RNA is found both in nucleus as well as in cytoplasm. There are three types of RNA. mRNA, that is called messenger RNA, rRNA, that is ribosomal RNA, tRNA means transfer RNA. mRNA carries the information for protein synthesis from genes on DNA chain in nucleus to the ribosomes in the cytoplasm. So it is called as messenger RNA. RNA, it helps in protein synthesis, and transfer RNA present in the cytoplasm and it carries specific amino acid up to the ribosome. It carries specific amino acid up to the ribosomes as the message coded on mRNA, that is messenger RNA. Then we see another point, transcription, translation and translocation. Synthesis of mRNA as nucleotide sequence present on DNA molecule is called as the process of transcription. This process is called as transcription. Process of RNA synthesis is called as transcription. Information required for the synthesis protein is stored in the genes, that is in the nucleotide sequence of DNA. The proteins are synthesized according to the need of the body. Synthesis of proteins by DNA through the RNA is called as central dogma. Genetic information is thus used from DNA to RNA, thus through RNA for protein synthesis. mRNA is produced according to the sequence of nucleotide of DNA. This is transcription process, that is synthesis of proteins by DNA through RNA, and this is also called as central dogma. Then we see triplet codon. The code for which amino acid consisting of three nucleotide is called as triplet codon. Messenger RNA formed in nucleus brings the coded message from DNA when it comes in cytoplasm. This message contains the codes for amino acid. Dr. Har Govind Khorana made an important contribution in the discovery of triplet codon for 20 amino acids. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1968 for this work. Thousands of triplet codons are present in messenger RNA. Formation of peptide bonds. Every transfer RNA brings specific amino acid. These individual amino acids are joined together by peptide bonds with the help of RNA. Then we see mutation. This is the diagram of mutation. Sudden change occurring in the genetic material is known as mutation. Due to transmission of parental genes to offspring, there is a remarkable similarity between parents and their offspring. But if there is a mutation, if any nucleotide, then there are changes in the characters of the offspring. Mutations are also two types, minor and major. Minor mutations can also bring about considerable changes. For example, genetic disorders like sickle cell anemia is caused due to mutation. Mutation is an overlasting process which leads to the process of evolution. And it also offers proof for Darwin's theory of natural selection. That is, here displacement occur and mutation process is formed. Thus, process of RNA synthesis is called transcription. As the codon on messenger RNA, the transfer RNA molecule with complementary anticodon is brought near messenger RNA. This process is called as translation. The ribosome keeps on moving from one end of messenger RNA to another end by the distance of the triplet codon. This process is called as translocation. And sudden change occurring in the genetic material is known as mutation. Now next point, evolution. The gradual change occurring in living organism over a long duration is called as evolution. Evolution results in the development of organism. Transformations ranging from changes in the stars and planets to the changes in biosphere on the earth and studied in the field of evolution. Due to evolution, there is a formation of new species. Due to natural selection, there are continual changes in specific characters of several generations of living organisms. Approximately 3.5 billion years ago, life was not present on the earth. The living organisms have been developed according to the following phases. First, simple elements, organic and inorganic elements, complex organic compounds such as proteins and nucleic acid. Mixture of different type of organic and inorganic compounds. First, primitive type of cells. Process of to take surrounding chemicals developed leading to growth of cell in numbers. First, living organism, those organisms that could adjust and adapt to surrounding condition, survived and grew. This is according to the principle of natural selection. Some of them that could not adjust, that is first from unicellular amoeba and paramecium to giant whale and man. Diversity of animals is also occur due to evolution. From unicellular plants, ranging diversity in plants from unicellular chlorella to the huge banyan tree. Existence of the life on the earth from equator to both the poles on the entire earth. Living organisms are seen air, water, land, rock, etc. Theory of this gradual development of living organisms is accepted worldwide. Now, is it clear? The gradual change occurring in living organism over a long duration is called as evolution. Now, we see next point, theory of evolution. First, living material is the protoplasm which was found in the ocean. This gave rise to unicellular organism in gradual time. Over the span of approximately 300 crores years, very gradual changes occurred in the unicellular organism which slowly evolved into larger and more complex life forms. All-round and multidimensional changes occurred which resulted in evolution of different type of organisms. Organization evolution, the progressive development of plants and animals over a very large time is called organizational evolution. Development of living organism from ancestors having different structural and functional organization is called evolution. Now we see evidences of evolution. Evolution is an everlasting process of changes. The proofs to support this process are called evidences of evolution, which are of following steps. Is it clear? Okay. Now read teaching concept carefully and try to write exercise. Please subscribe Sangli Shikshan Samstha's YouTube channel and click bell icon and get new notifications.